distinguished dignitaries on the dais, conference speakers, invitees, delegates, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am truly honored to address this seminar on a very topical issue of nation building through shipbuilding. It is also a privilege to get the opportunity to interact with this immense intellectual pool of experts on maritime issues that is assembled within the four walls of this hall. I would like to thank FICCI for hosting this seminar, our knowledge partner NMF, distinguished audience from the maritime community, industry, academia, and government organizations, as also all participants for supporting this seminar. And I'm confident that the proceedings would act as a springboard for implementable ideas to promote shipbuilding in India. The government has announced plans to take our country's economy on a trajectory to be a $5 trillion economy by 2024. And I think shipbuilding is a sector that can contribute immensely to this endeavor. And I'm sure several speakers today would discuss measures to spur on shipbuilding, especially commercial shipbuilding in India. But I will, however, dwell on the Indian Navy's shipbuilding initiatives and its linkage to nation building. As you all know, the Indian Navy is fully invested in encouraging the indigenous shipbuilding ecosystem. 50 years before Make in India became a national mission, the Navy took formative steps towards indigenous shipbuilding, and I thank all the predecessors, many of whom are sitting here, for this endeavor. And this was done through the creation of an in-house central design office in 1964. The Navy has to date designed more than 90 warships across 19 different classes. And with more than 130 platforms constructed in Indian shipyards since the first ship, INS Ajay, was constructed by GRSE in 1961, naval shipbuilding could be counted as one of the success stories of India. And this success story is testimony to the synergy between the Indian Navy and the industry, as also a commitment towards self-reliance. Yet we must acknowledge that this journey from buyer's navy to a builder's navy has been an arduous one. Today, whilst the Navy boasts of respectable percentages in ship construction and equipment in the float, move and fight components or categories, we remain fully cognizant of the challenges ahead. The fiscal environment calls for prudence and optimization of every rupee spent. And time and cost overruns in ship constructions create challenges for us who are trying to manage the budget of the Indian Navy. Also, strangely, shipbuilding being a capital intensive activity has created a bit of a narrative where budgetary allocation for naval shipbuilding is considered to be by some a drain on the economy. Yet I would argue that investing in naval shipbuilding is far from fiscal drain. And I'll take a few minutes to mention at least three reasons to explain what is sometimes perceived as a drain is not actually so. And that naval shipbuilding actually contributes handsomely to economic growth and nation building. The first reason I would like to state, I mean, it's nothing new, but I'll talk about is the plowback effect. By conservative estimates, a very large portion of every rupee spent on the Navy is plowed back into the Indian economy. To start with, more than 60% of the naval budget is dedicated to capital expenditure. And nearly 70% of this capital budget has been spent on indigenous sourcing, amounting to nearly rupees 66,000 crores in the last 5 years. Since the launch of Make in India in 2014, 80% of the AONs on cost basis have been awarded to Indian vendors. And as you know, of the total 51 ships and submarines on order at various shipyards as on date, 49 are being constructed indigenously. So this highlights the considerable levels of plowback of naval shipbuilding into the economy. Each shipbuilding project also creates logistics, spares and project support ecosystems comprising the OEMs, ancillary industry and very importantly, the MSMEs to support each platform. GRSC, Calcutta for instance, has nearly 2,100 firms registered to support ongoing naval shipbuilding projects. And then subsequent ship repair and maintenance requirements over nearly three decades of a platform or ship's life lead to considerable investment in domestic industry. Nearly 90% of ship repair by value is undertaken by Indian vendors and mostly MSMEs, implying that in addition to the capital budget, a high proportion of Navy's revenue budget is also being plowed back into the economy. So much for the plowback effect. The second contribution that I would like to state on of naval shipbuilding is as a catalyst for employment generation and skill development, which are present-day real challenges faced by our nation. There is a quote which says, give a man fish and feed him for a day, teach him fishing and feed him for a lifetime. Shipbuilding is such a skill activity. Each shipbuilding project involves considerable investment of manpower with commensurate employment and skilling of workforce. As platforms become more complex, skill levels are proportionately upgraded. Naval shipbuilding projects have made considerable, if often less acknowledged, contribution towards employment and skilling. Studies show that labor employed for a given sum of industrial turnover is one of the highest in shipbuilding industry. Complexity of warship construction also implies much higher manpower absorption vis-a-vis the commercial construction. For instance, the manpower required to build commercial ships of about 30,000 tons is less than the manpower employed for warship construction of around 6,000 tons. In addition, the warship construction requires a much higher ratio of white-collared workers vis-a-vis blue-collared workers, given the inherent complexities involved. So thus, employment opportunities are extended to more widespread educational backgrounds. And given the high number of unemployed educated youth in our country, this is a very important driver. In addition, statistics show that the multiplier effect of one worker employed in a shipyard is approximately 6.4 on ancillary industry. Project 17 Alpha frigates, for instance, would employ a workforce of about 4,500 workers in the two yards, but nearly 28,000 personnel per year as outsourced manpower will be employed in ancillary industry. Apart from individual skilling, naval projects also lead to creation of new capacities within shipyards. These are crucial spin-offs for the economy. India's largest dry dock, which is under construction at Cochin Shipyard, for instance, would enable servicing of large-size commercial ships, apart from aircraft carriers, which was one of the prime movers for the project. Similarly, as brought out, the requirement of indigenous steel for ISC1 has led to development of the indigenous DMR 249 Alpha steel from DMRL, Hyderabad, which is being employed in other naval projects as well. So the SAIL has supplied nearly 50,000 tons of indigenous steel, which was hitherto being imported. So in essence, shipbuilding has potential to contribute to other sectors as well as in ways both tangible and intangible. Finally, naval shipbuilding projects contribute to strategic outcomes for nations as well. We all know that multi-dimensional ships, state-of-the-art ships constructed by the industry, our industry, for the Navy and the Coast Guard, are crucial to protecting India's maritime interests in the Indian Ocean region and beyond. In addition, Navy's diplomatic engagements and capacity-building efforts have also allowed several friendly countries to harness our shipbuilding prowess. We have already added capacities of friendly nations such as Seychelles, Maldives and Sri Lanka, to name a few, by exporting warships that enhance their overall security. So as India's shipbuilding industry matures, there is immense potential to forge strategic partnerships and convert India into a hub for defense shipbuilding exports and repairs to friendly foreign countries. But to enable such strategic outcomes, there is a need for the nation to achieve a certain critical mass in indigenous ship production and ship repair capability. whilst defense shipbuilding plays an important role, we actually really need to harness the headroom which is available in sectors such as mercantile marine and coastal shipping to increase capacities and attain our true potential. Having said all this, I would like to conclude by reassuring the audience of the Indian Navy's unrelenting focus on indigenous ship construction and capacity development. As the first service to operationalize the strategic partnership model, conclude contracts under the buy and make Indian category, and contract prototype development under make to project, we are committed to partnering the industry in our collective quest for greater self-reliance. With that, I wish the seminar all success. I'm happy to note the encouraging response received from all stakeholders, and I'm sure that the discussions will strengthen efforts to revitalize the shipbuilding ecosystem in the country. Thank you. Jai Hind.